Dubbed the supermodel grannies, they're a group of middle-aged mice that are defying aging using a drug that's been made for humans. So has the secret to living a longer life been at last unlocked?
Cheating death.
For the first time in history, we can now think about living forever.
It's long been the holy grail of medicine.
If you reach the year 2045 in good health, you don't have to die anymore.
Scientists have rejuvenated the skin cells taken from a 53-year-old woman, making them equivalent to those of a 23-year-old.
The pursuit of immortality, a Silicon Valley favourite pastime.
I'm getting 300 million mesenchymal cells put into my body and each joint.
Backed by governments, scientific institutions and tech moguls, the business of turning back time is projected to be worth more than $65 billion by 2030.
It's the ultimate human desire, right? The one thing that we all face are limits on our own mortality.
Now, after years of being promised humanity is on the brink of a breakthrough, scientists have discovered that a drug developed to treat lung disease increases the lifespan of mice by nearly 25%.
Which is, you know, relatively impressive.
The lab mice, dubbed supermodel grannies for looking so youthful despite their age, were injected with the drug at 75 weeks old, the equivalent of 55 years in humans, and treated with it until their death. Not only did the supermodel grannies develop fewer cancers, they were leaner, stronger, and had super glossy fur.
The mice had stronger muscles. They had better lungs, they had better skin, they had better hearing, they had better vision.
The drug attacks a gene which produces a protein called interleukin-11, linked to conditions including inflammation, muscle wasting and frailty. The protein levels increase as we get older.
We're able to turn the gene off. And what we see is aging diseases are much improved.
The hope? The drug could produce similar results in humans.
The problem is when you go to translate this to humans in a big clinical trial, you need to recruit thousands and thousands of people and wait quite literally until they die of old age. So it's the longest and most expensive clinical trial you could possibly imagine.
Tonight, the Fountain of Youth might just be one step closer.
This isn't the ultimate cure, but if translated to humans, it would have a fantastic impact on our lifespans and our overall health. So look, it's one advance for the field. It's certainly not as far as we can get. We can go much further.
My favourite thing at the end there was that terrifying sci-fi score that we put underneath that.
We're going to live forever.
Those mice looked very good. Their hair was very shiny. They were looking hot.
How often are you looking at mice, Jessie?
Look, I was like supermodel grannies. Like, that sounds hyperbolic. And then I looked at them and I was like, they're supermodels. Yeah. What can I say? Yeah. They are looking very good.
Would this be something that you would consider? Like, the thought of living forever or slowing the aging process? Like,
I've been scared about the idea of just prolonging life without much of a discussion of what that life looks like. I don't want to live very old for the sake of it. You want your quality of life to be very good till the end.
True.
And what I love about this is that it's kind of freezing, like sort of where you're at, and allowing it. That's what I love.
But where would you want to be frozen?
Oh.
If you got to choose. 40s? We are years away from this.
40s?
40s. Oh,
yeah. You want your 40s?
Yeah.
Wow.
What do you reckon?
Oh. 8 years old, I reckon. Like, no responsibilities.
But, mate, in so many ways, you've achieved it.
I'm here already.